Wildlife is a public resource owned by all of us. State wildlife agencies manage this resource so that everyone can enjoy it for years to come. This big job becomes more difficult when managing diseases like chronic wasting disease. However, experts provide science-based best management practices to help guide responses before and after CWD is found. The exact approach may vary across regions because of different circumstances. However, there are four key approaches to CWD: prevention, surveillance, communication, and working to slow the spread and reduce prevalence. The saying, "an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure," is so true for CWD. Actions that may prevent CWD introduction include: only move processed meat or finished taxidermy instead of whole carcasses from infected areas, properly dispose of unwanted parts, and don't illegally move live deer, which may carry CWD undetected. Surveillance may include testing harvested deer at check stations, taxidermists, and meat processors. Other examples of surveillance include sampling roadkill or sampling sick-looking deer. Early detection of CWD allows early implementation of mitigation measures that may help limit future spread. Wildlife agencies work to keep everyone informed by putting out press releases, using social media, hosting public meetings, and much more. Lastly, agencies may attempt to slow CWD spread by restricting baiting, feeding, and mineral licks. They often encourage harvest with increased bag limits and hunting seasons to reduce deer density, possibly coupled with targeted removal after the season if needed. These approaches are based on the latest scientific research, which may change as new information comes out. CWD makes us adjust the way we do things, which can be challenging, but we all need to work together for the long-term good of the resource and our enjoyment of recreational hunting. Thanks for watching. Hit that like button and subscribe for more videos on CWD and deer.